Hello friends, welcome to worksheet series. This worksheet will really help you to solve the case studies in the board exam. Alright, so see the full video and check yourself how much understanding is there about the concepts related to this chapter. Alright, let's start with the first question. Name the function of management which coordinate the physical, financial and human resources and establishes productive relationship among them for the achievement of specific goals. Alright, so you can see the coordinate is in which things they have to coordinating physical, financial and human resources. Alright, so it is none other than it is organizing. Alright, so this function of management is doing all these things. Let's move for the next question. It is like this. Name the two steps in process of organizing which comes after identification and division of work and departmentalization. Alright, so first step of organizing is identify and division of work, and afterwards departmentalization is there. So next will come what you have to do. You have to assign duties, assignment of duties, and what you have to do, you have to establish reporting relationship. Last is establish reporting relationship. That is the next one. Alright, let's go for the next one. Hindustan Lever Limited is manufacturing computer shops and textile. Which type of organizational structure would suit the requirement of such organization? Here you can see the variety of product is there, shop, textile, computers. So obviously the best type of divisional structure is divisional structure. Alright, so for different category of product, different structure will be there. Different organizational structure will be adopted here. Next, you can see the third word is remain here. Amar Limited is manufacturing ready-made garments for kids and has production, sales, purchase and finance department. Which type of organization structure would you suggest? Here, only ready-made garment for kids is there. So obviously it will be more suitable is functional structure. Okay, so here functional will come and here the divisional will come. Next is number 5. It is a system of consciously coordinated activity for two or more person towards the common objective. Mention this system of organization and list its two features. Alright. So here what happened, you can see system of conscious coordination. When system of conscious coordination we are talking about, it is none other than it is a formal organization. It is formal organization and you can write any two features of it, like it is deliberately formed by top management and it emphasizes more on work. There are many features you can write down here. Next is number 6. It is a network of personal and social relations not established or required by formal organization but assigning spontaneously as people associate with one another. Name this. So here you can see what type of communication is going on here. Social and personal relationship is developed spontaneously. So it is informal organization. Informal organization. Next is there, it refers to the systematic delegation of authority from top management to lower level managers. Mention and name it. So when we talk about here, see, systematic delegation is there and it is starting from top to lower level managers. So it is decentralization. Next, the employee of ABC Limited take part in volleyball matches on Sunday, name the type of organization formed. Obviously, it is unofficial, non-official, so it is informal organization. Next, state whether the principle of scalar chain is followed in informal organization or not. So obviously in informal they are not following any chain of communication, so it is not followed. The first step in process of organizing is identification of work. Why is he work divided into manageable activities? So why they are doing this, why they are dividing the work into manageable activities, they are asking here. So they are doing just one reason is there behind this, to avoid, they want to avoid duplication of work. And same time to reduce the burden of work. Burden of manager also you can see. So two things are there, why they are doing this, they are dividing this to avoid the duplication of work. At the same time they have also want to reduce the work of manager. Next is while allocating work to various employees, how the work must be assigned. So whenever you are assigning the work to employee, at that time which things you have to keep in mind here. So here we have to keep in mind their skill, what is their skill, skills, their abilities, and their competency. So these three things we have to keep in mind, what they have skill, what is their ability, what kind of competency they have, and on the basis of this you can assign the work. Okay, let's move for the next page. Here you can see next page, the question is like this. Which function of management is concerned with building a stable frame work or structure of various parts of an enterprise? So here you can see the function of management is related to building a stable frame, that is none other than organizing only. So organizing is a one kind of framework within which the all persons of the organization is functioning. Alright, let's move for the next. How can department or divisions are created? Department or division, how they are created? It is simply what we are doing, we are grouping the similar jobs. And departmentalization. So like this way the different division or department is created. Next is, how does the informal organization emerge? When we are talking about informal organization is emerge due to people interact with each other. People interact with each other as well as they are talking beyond their official role. Like this way it is created. Unofficially they are meeting with each other and they are interacting, and like that way the informal organization is emerged. Name the organization which has the benefit of easy fixed responsibility. In which type of organization easily fixed responsibility? Yes, obviously it is formal organization, because they are following scalar chain, assignment of duties are there, so it is easy to fix. Name the type of organization which does not have a predetermined objectives. They are not predetermined objective, obviously it is informal organization. Next one is there. A fashion design house has the following major job: manufacturing, finance, marketing, personnel, research and development. Here they are talking about personnel, not personal, okay? So which organizational structure will you prefer for this type of company? obviously it is for, we will prefer functional structures. Okay, fashion house design, fashion design house is there. Next is like Mohini runs a shoe manufacturing factory. She wants to expand her business. For expansion, she contemplated to enter into manufacturing of leather bags, western formal apparels. Apart from the running business of shoe, by doing this, her company will be able to provide many products to working women under the one roof. Which type of, which organizational structure would you suggest? The first question is which type of structure we will suggest, because she wants to do a very diversification is there, shoe, leather bag, formal wear. So obviously we will prefer her divisional structures. Next question is there. Name the activity which increase the importance and role of subordinates. Obviously it is decentralization. Decentralization is there. In decentralization, the role of subordinate is increasing all the time, because we are doing the sharing of authorities there, sharing of responsibility. Next, which kind of enterprise functional structure is more suitable? So when we are talking about functional structure, obviously it is suitable for large type of organization, as they are producing one kind of products. So functional structure is best for them. Next, name the concept which refers to number of subordinate that can be effectively managed by superior. Alright, so it is a definition of span of management. Next, name the process of entrusting responsibility, authority and creating accountability of the person whom work has been handed over. So this is a process of delegation. This is process of delegation. In delegation only this responsibility, authority is imparted or handed over to other person. Next, state the relationship between authority, responsibility and accountability. When we are talking about this thing, relationship is there at that time. So we can say the responsibility is coming from authority, and accountability at other time, accountability is coming from responsibility. So this thing is there. Responsibility is coming from accountability, and accountability is coming from responsibility. So this is a relationship between them. You can write other points also. What should growing company adopt, centralization or decentralization policy? Obviously it is decentralization policy they have to adopt when they are growing. Okay, let's move for the next questions, the last page of this this worksheet. Question number 23, the number of subordinate that can be effectively managed by superior refers to which aspect of management? Obviously this is repeated question, it is a span of management. Next is grouping the jobs similar, grouping of similar nature and organizing these jobs as a separate department, create a particular type of organizational structure, name it. It is a functional structure. Next, out of functional organization structure, divisional structure, which is more costly? Obviously the divisional is more costly, because in divisional structure there will be separate departments, financial department, purchase department, production department, everything will be separated for every each product. So it is obviously more costly. Next questions are like this. An organization is dash when decision making authority retained by the higher management level, whereas it is dash when such authority is delegated. So here they are talking about two concepts. Two concepts are one that is a centralized, all right, and another one is decentralized. So when you are keeping authority with yourself, it is centralized. When you are sharing it with others, that is decentralized. Next question. Out of three elements of delegation, dash flow downward from superior to subordinate, but dash and dash flow upward. So they are talking about the three main concepts of this chapter, and it is what it is. First one is authority. All right. Authority is flowing downwards from superior to subordinate, but other two things, that is responsibility and accountability. It is flowing upward from subordinate to superior. Next, a network of social relationship that arise spontaneously due to interaction at work is called what? Is called informal organization. Next, out of formal and informal organization, which one is established first? Obviously, first is coming formal organization. And from the formal organization, within the formal organization, informal organization is developed. Next is what? What would be the effect of no delegation of work? No delegation of work. If you are not giving work to anyone, what will be happen? What will be the result? Result will be there will be delay in work. Delay in work, you can say delay in decision also, because one person has to take all the decision. So it will be overburdened. Person will be overburdened. What will be the result of this overburden of management manager? Next, the span of management determine two things. Span of management determine two things. What the two things are there? First, effectively, how many subordinates, you can say, how many subordinates can be effectively managed? Managed by manager. This thing is determined. First is how many subordinates can be effectively managed. At the same time, level of management. How many levels you have to manage. If the span of management is less number of subordinates are there, the level will be increased. Next questions. The manager cannot escape from the responsibility from any default or mistake on a part of his subordinates. Name this principle. Alright, this is not principle, but this is called accountability. Accountability cannot be ignored. We cannot say it cannot be completely delegated to someone, or it cannot be given to someone. Accountability is still there. Before delegation even, and after delegation, the same type of accountability, that means same answerability is there. The manager is answerable to in the same manner before, even before delegation and after delegation also. Next, difficulty in interdepartmental coordination is one of the limitation of which organizational structure? So interdepartmental coordination, it is obviously divisional structure is there, in which this problem is seen. Divisional structure, it is very difficult to coordinate with each other. Next, name the organization which is directed by group norms. Alright, group norms they are following. They are not following organizational norms. They are following group norms. It is informal organization. Next one is like this. If we dash work, we multiply by 2. If we dash, it will be multiplied by many. Oh yes, it is what? It is delegation. First is delegation. Delegation of work. When we delegate the work, it is multiplied by 2. But if we dash, that is a decentralization. When we do decentralization, it is multiplied by many. Next, a manager increased the production target from 800 to 1000 units per month, but the authority to draw the raw material was not given by him. Then meet the target, who should be held responsible for this, and which principle has been violated here? So here, person who is responsible, obviously manager is responsible, because once you are giving the responsibility, at the same time you must have to give the authority also at the same level, then only the organizational objective can be achieved easily. But if there is a misbalance, the organizational objectives are not going to be achieved. So here, what principle has been violated here? Authority and responsibility. There is no balance between them. Authority and responsibility, there should be balance between authority and responsibility, then only the person can achieve the target. Alright, so here we are completing this worksheet. This worksheet is really very helpful in solving the case studies. The PDF file of this worksheet is given in description, so you can see the description, you can download it, you can share with your friends. I hope you are liking this series of worksheet. Thank you very much.